So the question was about coin distribution. It was asked in Code Beta 2019 in Zone 1. And there was some confusion about this question yesterday. Let me just clear that confusion for you, and then we'll quickly move on to the next question. Okay. So opening up the question, here I go. All right. So this is the question. So we have to find the minimum number of coins that are required to form any value between 1 to n. For those of you who were on my session yesterday, this might seem a little repetitive, but I'll just cover this little quickly so that we can go on to the next questions. So we have to form any value between 1 to n, both inclusive, but we can use only coins which are 1 rupee, which are 2 rupee, and which are 5 rupee. Okay, so just coming back to the slides and understand this question properly. Okay, so one second. So just coming back to the slides. All right, so what we have over here are we are given of 1 rupee coins. We can choose 1 rupee coins, we can choose 2 rupee coins, or 5 rupee coins. Okay, let me represent like this. The number of 1, 2, and 5 rupee coins that we're going to take, we're going to represent. We can choose 5 rupee coins, 2 rupee coins, or 1 rupee coin. For example, to represent 1, we can represent it as 0, 0, 1. That is, we need just 1 1-rupee coin. To represent 5, we have multiple ways. So what we could do is we could use 1, 0, 0. That is, we can just use 5, and we can generate 5 by using just 1 5-rupee coin, 0 2-rupee coins, and 0 1-rupee coin. Or we can do 0, 2, 1. That is, we can use 2 2-rupee coins and 1 1-rupee coin. Or we can also do 0, 0, 5. This is also one of the ways that we can do 0 5-rupee coins, 0 2-rupee coins, and 1 5-rupee coins, right? So we have many ways of representing a number using 5, 2, and 1 rupee coins. Okay. The question though is that given a number, let's say if the number is 5, we need to find the optimal arrangements of 5, 2, and 1 rupee coins such that not only can we make 5, but we can also make 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay. If you use 1, 0, 0, definitely you can make 5, but you can't make 2, 3, 4, or 5. Okay. That's the problem over here. So how do we go about solving this? Well, if you did 0, 2, 1, okay, that means you can use 2 2-rupee coins, 1 1-rupee coin. Can we form 1 through this? Yes, we can form 1. Can we form 2 through this? Yes, we just take 1 2-rupee coin and we can form it. Can we form 3 through this? Yes, 1 2-rupee coin and 1 1-rupee coin. Can we form 4? Yes, 2 2-rupee coins. Can we form 5? Yes, we can form 5. So if we do 0, 2, 1, then we can form 5 also. 5 and all of the numbers up to 5, right? Okay. Could we have done 1, 2, 1? Yes, we could have done 1, 2, 1 also. All of these numbers would have formed. The problem is though, the question has a second part. Thus, the question says, whichever configuration of coins you take, one, it has to form all of the numbers up till n. So when I've given you n, it's not only n, but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all the way up to n. Second, the maximum number that can be formed by the given coins should not exceed n. So over here, the maximum number we can form is 5 plus 2 into 2, 4, plus 1 into 1, 5. So 5 plus 4 plus 1, which is equal to 10. But in this case, we have 0 plus 4 plus 1, which is equal to 5. So in this case over here, the maximum number we can form is 5. This case, the maximum number we can form is 10. Hence, 0 to 1 is the optimal solution. Okay, let's just go back to the question just to wrap it up. All right, so I'm just going back to the question right now. Okay, so what we have over here is, consider a value of n is 13, then the minimum number of coins required to formulate any value between 1 and 13 is 6. That is, we require 1 5 rupee coin, 3 2 rupee coin, and 2 1 rupee coins are required. Okay, so again for 13, what it says is we need 1 5 rupee, 3 2 rupee, and 2 1 rupee. So that's 1, 3, 2. That's what we require, right? So for 13, we require 1, 3, 2. Okay. So 13, we have 1, 3, 2. So I already discussed this question a little bit yesterday. You can watch yesterday's webinar for a more detailed discussion. But basically speaking, right, what does this question want us to do? This question wants us to figure out the minimum number of coins required. So the coins that we use, so over here we use 1 plus 3, 4 plus 2, 6. We use 6 coins over here. This has to be minimum. And also, the maximum number formed by 132 cannot exceed 13. Okay, so it has to form the same number and it has to be the minimum number of coins possible. Okay, well, as I was discussing yesterday, one of the strategies that you can use is, let's say you're given a big number, right? So if you're given a big number, let's say the number is something like 57. Okay, the biggest coin we have is a 5 rupee coin. That's the biggest coin we have. Okay, if we try to reach 50, or not, let's not even say 50. If we try to attack the maximum number using 5, we just need to ensure that there is enough change remaining such that we can formulate the rest of the number. What does that mean? We have 57. Imagine if we were able to get up till 50 using 5s. Because the easiest way to get up to 50 is through 5s. We just need 10 5 rupee coins. The remaining 7 change, if we can somehow figure out through 5, 2s and 1s, right, then we are done. Right, so if we figure out 7 how to do it, then we will get our answer 57 in the least number of coins. Also, any number in the middle can also be formed from these coins. For example, if I take 57, if I had to make 47, I won't take 10, I'll just take 8 from the 5s and I'll ensure that 7 can be made from the change. Why? Because we picked 7 such that it could be made from the change. That's what we did. Now, how do we make 7 from the change? We'll just come to it. But 47 can be made. What about 43? Even 43 can be made. We use 8 5s and 3 can be made because we chose 7 such that not only 7 could be made, but 1, 2, 3, so on till 7 could be made. That is how we chose the 7 change. Okay. So we get to the nearest possible value that we can using 5s, and after that, the change we will try to make through our change, okay, to the 3, 2 and 1. Okay, now how do we figure out how we can actually do this, right? If we have to actually figure this out, there are more test cases than this. For example, if we had to do it for 57, which we just said, we have to get to 50 and then we have to add 7 coins. But if we have to do it for, let's say, 51, we can't do 50 plus 1 coins, right? If we do 50 plus 1 coins, we will have a problem. The reason is, we will never be able to make a number like 47. Because what we'll end up doing is, we'll create 10 coins for 50 and we'll just take 1 coin here, okay? But when we have to do 47, we'll take the 8 5 coins that we have over here. So we have 8 5 coins, so that we got 40. Plus, we are never able to get a 7 because we only have a 1 rupee spare change. Okay, so this needs a little bit more thinking. Okay, instead of taking up to 50, in this case for 51, if we had split it up like this, 45 plus 6, if we had split it up like that, then what can happen is, for 51, what we did is, we took 9 5 rupee coins plus whatever change is required to get to 6. When we say change required for 6, it's not only 6 but all the numbers from 1 to 6. Okay, so now what's going to happen? Let's take a number like 33. Can we make it just from this 9 plus 6 change? Yes, we can, because we will take 6 5 rupee coins, okay, and plus the 3, we can generally make it because we have 6 change. That is, we can generate any number from 1 to 6, right? So we can just generate any number between 1 to 6. So 6 plus whatever is the change that is required. If you notice, we will never need a number greater than 6 change, because we can always reach the nearest 5, and from there we are able to generate the nearest from the change. Because let's say if we had to make 28, we'll again use 4 5 rupee coins plus or not even 4 5 rupee coins, 5 5 rupee coins will reach 25, and again we need only 3 change, and the 3 change can be again got from 6, right? So what we have over here are two cases. We have got two cases over here. We've got the first case where the number is, let's say, something like this, okay? The number is a number that is, okay, all right. So, yeah, I'll check the comments in some time. But, so, the number is something like this, okay? The number is, let's say, if I've given two types of numbers, okay? The numbers are one that is greater than a 5 and one that is lesser than a 5. Let's say the number is something like 37. And the number is something like 32, okay? Or it could be anything, but the unit's digit, okay, let's call this number x, and again whatever the number, and let's call this number again x. If x is greater than 5, okay, then we have a certain logic. If x is less than 5, then we have a certain logic, okay. If we have x greater than 5, right, so that's our number like 36, 37 and so on, we generate 5s, we use 5s to generate up till 30, and the remaining change we will have to generate, okay, using 5, 2 and 1 rupee coins we will generate the remaining change. But up to reach to 30, what we're going to do is we're going to use 5 rupee coins, okay. For x less than 5, let's say we have something like 31, 33, we don't reach to 30, we try to reach to 25 using 5 rupee coins, and the remaining change, so let's say there's something like 33, the remaining change 8 we make through the change, okay. So that's what we're going to do, we're going to make it through the change. I'll just move myself. So what I said over here was 31 or 33, if we have 25, we reach 25 using 5 rupee coins, and the remaining part we are going to make using the change, okay. Now how does that exactly work? Okay, we've been continuously talking about change, and reaching the 5, that is the nearest 5, is the easy part, right? If we have these two conditions, then we can very easily reach the 5s. And if it's equal to 5, then just choose one of the cases. It's pretty much the same thing, okay? But to reach any one of the 5s, that is to reach 25 or to 30, calculating the 5s is easy. It's the change that is the problem, okay? And to get the change, what you should do is actually manually calculate all of the changes, okay? And that's what we had done. We were discussing yesterday. We have a table over here, right? To get one, the maximum, the best configuration that we can get is 0, 5 rupees, 0, 2 rupees, 1, 1 rupee, okay? To get a number, let's say like 6, this is the best configuration. 0, 5 rupees, 2, 2 rupees, and 1, and 2, 1 rupees, okay? So 0, 2, 2 is the best configuration. Now, how did we get this? How will you get this during Code Vita? Don't worry about it, okay? The fact is, you should actually start from this table, okay? Start making this table. Whenever you get such a question, at least start making from 1 to 10. You will start noticing a pattern coming up, okay? You will start noticing a simple pattern coming up over here. For example, you can see that after 8, 9 over here is a repetition. That is, you got 1, 2 again. Then you got 2, 1 again at 5, right? It's just that one more 5 rupee coin was added over here. So you will start seeing a little bit of repetition. And once you get the repetition, you can come up with this logic of attacking the nearest 5, okay? So this is the configuration from 1 to 10. Now that we have the configuration from 1 to 10, we know we have to reach the nearest 5. Reach the nearest 5, and the remaining change you can just generate from 1 to 10 or from 1 to 9. Okay, so the approach would be something like this. Reach the nearest 5 less than the number using 5 coins, and then remaining numbers can be reached using our table. Okay, and for those of you who are a little bit still confused, this is what I'll do. I'd suggest that you go to our Edis platform. There is a coin distribution tutorial, and over here we have adopted about 3 cases just to show you, although you can just divide it into 2 cases, but go and read the tutorial and you will get the entire logic. I've even kept the entire pseudo code over here, which is very similar to the Java code I used. So please go ahead and check the tutorial out if you are still stuck on this question. Okay, it's not too difficult a question. The way you should know that it's not too difficult a question is, this was the first question. So this was question number A. Don't be scared. You should know that if it's question 1 or question 2, it's going to be an easy question. It's just they've twisted it a little bit. So if you see yourself trying to do too many for loops, too many while loops, think that the first question and second question are really not worth it. They're not worth spending time to do for loops and while loops. Think that there must be a simpler solution. Okay, and here this is the simpler solution. So if you just think about it a little bit, you'll get it. Try to discuss the logic with your friends. Try to do a little bit test case bouncing. See what are the test cases, and as per the test cases, try to generate the code. Okay.